My year so far.
Welcome to Badger Lodge. The other day we managed to get out in between the weather that we've had lately and go and drift over the Shambles banks, and we were targeting Turbot and Place.
It is a turbo wimmo.
turbo wimmo.
Nice one.
That's drift. That's all right, isn't it?
Yeah, that's result. Proper result. Nice.
Only a little one, nice and dark, look at that.
Yeah.
Nice looking. Looks nice though.
Yeah.
Not a massive one, but.
Look nicer being goujon.
The start of the Shambles.
That's making up for last trip, maybe.
Yeah, yeah. Well, he had to catch up. Time, he had to catch up straight away, didn't he?
We had a really good day out, and the other guys caught quite a few turbot.
It's a nice one.
Beautiful.
Nice, Pete. That's a lovely fish.
Gotcha.
I only got one, but I got a really, really good one. Look at this for a beast. Just had this lovely specimen. Look at that. Yes, look at that.
That's a chunk of a fish, Dave. It's a beauty, mate. It is a beauty. Dustbin lid.
It would be wrong not to do something nice with such a good fish. The turbot is known to be the king of the sea. It is probably the most expensive fish per pound that you can buy in the UK. Hopefully I can do this some justice. I'm going to make pan-fried turbot with new potatoes, with chorizo and asparagus on the side, with some cod goujons to go around alongside the dish. Hopefully I could do this right. I'm not a chef and I struggle with cooking cereal or toast sometimes, so this could end up going really, really badly, but I just want to try and do this some justice because this fish was actually my personal best. And I'm going to start by just making sure that I can make some goujons out of this cod. Let's take a really sharp knife. It's not a filleting knife, but what I want to do is just de-skin it. So I need to put that across like that. I need to remember to purchase a bigger cutting board, really. So I just want to de-skin this. So I'm just going to literally go through the tail end, and I'm going to pull the fish along the skin while just making sure that knife is as low down as possible. So we want these as goujons, so we want to try and make them stay together. Oh, there's a bone there. So I'm gonna just do big chunky goujons, I think. Like so. There's something about catching your own fish and doing your own thing with it. Make sure that these are dry because these are going to go into flour and so on. So I'm just going to lay these out. Nice big chunky cod. Let them sit for a little. And now on to the turbot. Pick up them bits. So, I want this to be pretty presentable. I'm going to leave the skin on because I'm pan frying, but you can just feel all them knobbly bits. I'm not sure how to attack this. I think I'm going to get rid of the thin bit and maybe into three. So, here we go. Just cut through them knobbly bits. Nice. So I think I'm going to just use that bit for now. But look at that. This fish is absolutely superb. I'm going to put that in the fridge. Or in fact, let's just need to leave that little bit for later. I want to take a bit of butter, a nice healthy bit of butter. As in heart attack butter. So we're going to get that to get hot. So there's a group of us, and we often go out on fishing adventures, and we tend to cook this type of style in the back of a truck in a car park next to a marina. The guys who know, and it's absolutely outstanding sometimes, especially after a long, long day. So what we need for this is we need an egg, flour, and breadcrumbs. Breadcrumbs, flour, egg. So it's quite an easy process. Let's get this the right way around. So you start off with putting some cod or whatever fish you're using in some flour, and this dries it out. It stops any moisture getting through. And then we dip it in egg. We let that drip off, straight into breadcrumbs. We'll beat the flour off, mix it in egg, and in the breadcrumbs. And what you tend to do is just roll it around. Just like so. Give it just a coating of salt, just a little, and quite a bit of pepper just over the top of them. Nice, we've got nice hot butter there. So let's put another pan on and get some more butter in that. I'd use oil, but I think butter is the way forwards with this. It's got to be nice, isn't it? Mm. We are that one. Go lower heat. This a shake. Now we're going to add this lovely, lovely bit of turbot. And I'm going to go skin down first and give it a good cook with the skin down to hold it together. Potatoes to steam instead of boil. Get them going. These cod fillets want to be flipping over now, so, or maybe a bit too much done. Let's get the right tool to do that. That should do for now. Okay, we'll turn the heat off there. So I want to try and keep the skin on here, so I'm just going to just move it a bit. I'm going to hold the fillet as I turn it over. Like that, lovely. Look at that. So I'm just going to pick out a lovely cod goujons. Very, very simply done. Let them dry out. I think that one turned to a bit of mush. Let me get rid of that water. So I'm just going to tail these. Now the good stuff. If you've got the king of fish, you want the king of pork, which has got to be chorizo. Nice and finely chopped. Straight in there. Right then. Lovely. That's now looking lovely. Which I'm going to take one of these. Cod goujons. A nice bed of asparagus. Then I'm going to make a quick little sauce. Very simple. And we're just going to drip that over. And that is what I've done with my turbot. That is looking fantastic. A little bit of chorizo. Mm. Wow. Well, I've outdone myself. That is better than cereal. What are the cod goujons like? Oh. Lush. Well, I'm going to carry on eating this. See you later.